Folks, I've had a few calamities at home. My rotting back steps finally collapsed, our dripping shower turned into a drizzle, and our bathroom sink pretty much stopped draining altogether. If that wasn't enough, my dad calls and says he's driving through town and will be by tomorrow for a visit. I don't know what your relationship is like with your dad. With my dad, I would be embarrassed for him to see me in my broken down house and that I don't know how to fix these problems. I needed a simple and fast way to fix each of these issues. At the hardware store, to fix the rotten steps, the associate sold me special screws that didn't require pre-drilling. For the dripping shower, he sold me washers and springs, and for the clogged drain, I bought a barbed plastic stick to fish out any clog. All of these were simple and fast solutions. When I arrived home with my supplies, I completed the work just before my dad pulled into the driveway. Well, I didn't get all of the planks down, but I was proud of my accomplishments. Simple and fast. I'm Jason Secosky. I'm a senior manager in research and development at SAS. I'm coming to you with simple ways to make your data steps run faster in SAS Viya. SAS Viya comes with two compute engines, traditional SAS and Cloud Analytic Services, also known as CAS. In SAS, data step runs in one thread or core. With smaller data, it runs great. With big data, some data steps can take hours to run. CAS is composed of one or more machines, and data step runs in all available cores. By splitting the input data among the cores and running the data step in parallel in each core, your data steps complete faster. Today, we'll show how it's simple to code data steps that run faster in CAS. In particular, programs with a by statement. We'll also look at handling row order differences within by groups between SAS and CAS and merging tables. Let's get started with an example. Say we have this table of animal weights. We want to write a program to discover the minimum weight for each type of animal. One way to do this is to sort the data with proc sort, then to write a data step to discover the smallest weight in each group. To do this in CAS, we'll first need to load the data into CAS using a new live name engine. The way it is loaded onto the multiple machines, we cannot maintain the order of rows from the original data. Then we automatically group the rows by animal, and we can write a data step to run in parallel on each group to discover the minimum weights. If there is one slide you remember from this talk, this is it. Performance is improved by splitting data across machines and processing in parallel. So if you want to take a screenshot, this is your slide. Here's the SAS program that we use to do this, then we'll convert it to run in CAS. I'm using a live name statement to create a live ref to where my data is stored. Proc sort, I'm going to sort the animal's data set by the type of animal. And then my data step, this is data steps going to use first and last dot processing, and so we need to have a by statement. And on the first row of a group, we're going to set the minimum weight to missing. Then we're going to compute the minimum weight. And then on the last row of the group, we will output a row. And we get these results, which are the minimum weights for each kind of animal. So how do we tell DataStep to run this program in CAS instead of SAS? Well, first we need to load the data into CAS. Then we can create a libref for it, since that's where it's stored, and use that libref in the data step. Data step will see the data stored in CAS and will automatically run the data step in CAS. It's simple, simple, simple. Here's that code. So our CAS statement will connect to CAS and create a new CAS session. Proc Cache Utils, a new procedure. We use it to load our SAS dataset into CAS across the machines. Then we use the CAS Live Name engine to create a live ref to where the data is stored in CAS. And then my data step is the same. It's the same data step that I used in SAS. All I did was change the live ref to point the data step to the data in CAS. Data step detects this and automatically runs this data step in CAS. It is simple. It even gets simpler. You'll notice that there's no proc sort. Well, you know, there's no magic going on here. Grouping is still happening. When using the by statement in a data step, in a CAS data step, CAS creates a temporary table with the data grouped on the first by variable and then sorted within groups on all the by variables. And we'll see this where this is important in the next section. And when we run our program, we'll see that the results are the same. And if this was proc print output, you'll notice that the rows are output in a different order. I've got in SAS, it was in alphabetical order by animal. Here it's not alphabetical order anymore. And why is the order different? Well, this is reflecting the parallel nature of CAS. All of the worker machines are reporting their results in at the same time. So the order that SAS receives those rows is basically the order that they just happen to be coming in. If the row ordering is important in your reporting, you'll need to do some sorting on the SAS side. So how does the performance compare? With a million groups and 100 animals per group, SAS took about 41 seconds and CAS took about 22 seconds. So this was simple and fast. Whether you realize it or not, when using SAS datasets, the original order of that rows were added is maintained. When using proc sort, the rows within a group retain the same order as the original data set. This isn't the case in CAS and can seem not so simple until we understand what CAS is doing. Let's take a look at an example. Here's our animals data set again. Let's assume the rows in the animals data set were added in chronological order. So to find the latest animal weight, it would be the last row for that kind of animal because these were added in chronological order. Now to find this last animal weight, one way to do this would be to sort the data set with proc sort. Proc sort retains the original row order. So then we could write a data step to output the last row of each group. Let's take a look at the code that does this. After we've sorted the data, this data step uses a set with a by statement, and then on the last row of the group, we do an output, and we see this result if we were to proc print it. Now, after loading the data into, what would the code look like in CAS? Well, we'll do like we did in the last example. We will change the live ref to our CAS live ref to point us to where the data is stored. This will automatically run the data step in CAS and do the grouping on the CAS side. And let's take a look at the results. You'll see right away that they're different. And what's going on here? This doesn't seem very intuitive. The latest weight for the ant is not the same. Bird happens to be the same. Cat's not the same. Dog's not the same. What is going on? Well, let's go back to our diagrams to see what is happening. Once we've loaded the data into three CAS workers, the row order, the way that we load it, the row order is not maintained. And you can kind of see this in the diagram. When we use the by statement in our data step, the machines will shuffle the rows to form by groups. And the order within a group is not maintained from the original SAS data set. Then when our data step outputs the last row of each group, it isn't necessarily the latest weight, and we see a difference in the results. What we've done here is we've made a trade-off. This is comparing the SAS results to the CAS results. we've made a trade-off to, do we take the time to maintain the original order of the rows back in the SAS data set once we've loaded the data into CAS, or do we speed the program by not having to keep track of the order? We chose to speed the program. But what do we do to keep the row order within groups? CAS groups rows on the first by variable and sorts within each group on all of the by variables. What we need is another variable to sort on within our groups that represents the original order of rows. Oftentimes, your data set will already have such a variable. Usually it's something like date observed, like when did we observe the weight for this kind of animal. Then we could sort on that. But in this case that I've manufactured, there is no such variable, so we'll need to add one, and I'm calling it row ID. And here it is in the diagram. If we load our data set into CAS, and we have a new row ID column that represents the original order of rows in SAS, we can then put our row ID variable on our by statement so that we sort within groups by animal and row ID. CAS will do the shuffling to group the rows, and you can see we haven't done the sorting quite yet. Then the sorting occurs, and we've maintained the original row order that we had in SAS. Then we can write our data step that picks off the last row of each group, and we'll get the same results that we got in SAS. And here's what the code looks like. Our first data step is going to load our data into CAS. And what we're doing here is we're reading the rows with a set statement from the SAS location and writing it to the table in CAS. And I'm creating a new variable called row ID, which I assign the value of underscore n underscore, which essentially is the row number in SAS. And then I run the data step, this next data step in CAS, where I added the row ID to my by statement so that I group based on animal type. And then within each group, I'll sort on the animal type and the row ID. This gives my group the same row order that we would see in SAS. So while we've made a trade-off for speed, the program is still relatively simple once you know how CAS forms groups. Simple and fast. The merge statement combines rows from two or more data sets in SAS and in CAS. When used with a by statement, rows from the same by variable are combined. SAS sequentially reads each table, combining rows one observation at a time until there's no more rows to process. In CAS, by groups are assigned to threads to process in parallel. Each thread processes the by groups assigned to it until there's no more by groups to process. We're going for simple and fast here. Let's look at our diagrams for merging two tables based on a common variable in SAS, and then we'll do the same thing in CAS. In SAS, let's combine an animals table and a plants table on the variable common. To combine the tables, first they have to be sorted with proc sort. Then we can merge them with the data step. After loading our data into CAS, we have similar steps. When we use a by statement in a data step, CAS will automatically group the rows on the machines, and then we can perform the merge. Let's take a look at the SAS code for this, and then the CAS code. In SAS, first we sort both the animals and plants data sets. Then we have a data step that merges them. And this is what the results look like. Now, let's change the libref, like we did in the prior two sections, to automatically have data step run this program in CAS. In CAS, we don't need the sorting, as the presence of the by statement tells CAS to automatically group the rows. And here's our result. So this was simple. We used the same data step we were using in CAS, in SAS, changed the libref to get it to run in CAS, and we get the same answers. Note that the row order is different because of the way that all of the machines are sending the reporting their rows back to SAS, and they're all sending at the same time. If we needed to order this, we would need to do some sorting in SAS. And here are the times it took to do these merges. When we merged two tables of 100 million rows, SAS took about 94 seconds, and CAS took about 27 seconds. So this was simple, and it was fast. Accelerating your data steps in CAS is simple, especially when using by-group processing. If you have existing data step code that runs in SAS, you can simply change the libref from a SAS libref to a CAS libref to take advantage of multiple threads on multiple workers. If needed, you can use a row ID to coax CAS into producing the same results as SAS with accelerated performance. When my dad was coming to visit, I needed a simple and fast way to fix my house. Whether you are preparing tables for analysis, computing new values, or combining tables with set and merge, using data step in CAS gets you where you want to be faster. Simple and fast. Thank you.